Hi everyone, it's Neil Patel and this is another day of SEO Unlocked, and this week we're going to be going over mastering Google tools. But before we get started, I want to start off with a quote. It's from Oscar Wilde. Experience is simply the name we give our mistakes. And by going over Google's tools that they provide you, you'll be able to find errors and mistakes within your website so that way you can get results faster. But I want to go over a few household things before we dive in. First off, have you really done enough over the past 5 weeks? We've gone over 5 modules. The last one was link building. You should by now have implemented a lot of these things and you should start seeing results, because if you're not seeing measurable results already, something's off. And let us know, because we're here to help you and we want to make sure you're seeing results. So what I want you to focus on now is tracking your business goals, because if you track your business goals, you'll be able to quickly improve them and see results even quicker. And that's what you should be focusing on. But first off, if you didn't know exactly what was covered in the last 5 weeks or what you need to do step by step, you can go through the modules all over again, or you can download the SEO Taskmaster worksheet. It has all the action steps broken down for literally every single module, and this will help you get results and stay organized. You can find this at neilpatel.com/training. Click on SEO Unlocked, and then you'll see the files in the right videos. In addition to that, you want to measure and prioritize your musketeer intent. You want to make sure that you're getting value and you're setting goals for the next month, 2 months, 3 months, or even year. That way you can stay on track, because if you know what you're trying to achieve, you can break down what you need to do on a daily basis to hit those goals. So now let's focus on some of the tools that Google offers to help you measure and improve your results. There's Google Search Console and Google Analytics. And we have 3 main lessons for you. One of them is on Search Console and 2 are on Google Analytics. But this one is going to be focusing on Google Analytics, and then we'll dive into Search Console and then we'll go back to Analytics. Time is money when it comes to SEO. You know it takes a while to see results, so the last thing you want to do is focus on the wrong things. And the reason you want to use analytics is it helps you formulate a hypothesis about, hey, this is the type of content that's working and this was not working. This is the type of stuff that's building more links, more social shares, getting higher rankings. This is the stuff that's not working. These are the type of content and pages and keywords that are driving revenue versus, hey, these are the keywords that are driving traffic, but they're not generating one sale. And before we dive into analytics, I want to start with this quote: a goal without a plan is just a wish. So the first step in Google Analytics is going over, you guessed it, goals. A goal could be anything: someone purchasing from your website, someone becoming a lead. You want to measure anything that helps you generate revenue. In essence, that's what a goal will be. So log into your Google Analytics, click on Admin, and then on the right side, I want you to click on Goals. You'll see a screen that looks like this. I want you to click on Creating a New Goal, and then pick the template that most resembles you. A reservation could be a lead, or you can end up picking someone generating a sale or someone contacting you. There's so many different options here and they provide the templates. Select the one that's most relevant to the goal on your website and then give that goal a name. Once you do that, you would type in, or select more so, the type of goal it is or how someone finishes that goal. So that could be they visit a thank you page, or stay on the page long enough, or they exit, and you just select which one it is. The easiest one is usually, say, a destination, like driving them to a thank you page. And then on the next step, where it says equals to, you put your URL of your thank you page. So every time someone hits that, they know that, hey, you have a conversion. You'll also want to make sure once you create your goals that you turn them on. It's simple. I know this is obvious, but a lot of people make this mistake. No worries if you do, it's common. Make sure you turn them on. The next thing I want you to do is track your internal search queries. Remember how a lot of people use Google to do searches? Well, the chances are you have a search bar on your website and you wanna track it, what people are searching for on your website, because it'll give you ideas of content to create, what you need to optimize to generate more sales as well. So go back to Admin, and this time I want you to click on Settings. And when you click on Settings, you'll be able to scroll all the way down. I want you to turn on Site Search Tracking. And by turning it on, and you'll see another screen, just make sure you turn them all on. Once you end up doing that, it'll tell Google, hey, anytime someone searches on my website, track it. So that'll give you the data you need to make sure that when people are searching for specific things, like let's say your e-commerce company and everyone's searching for something, but you don't offer it, now you know you should probably offer it. Or if you're a lead generation provider and people are searching for some educational-based content and you don't have it, you should create it and then try to collect leads from that page. So when someone goes to your website, here's an example, they're searching, you'll see that they may have a specific URL string, like a question, S equals, and you just want to place that into the previous screen that I mentioned here, where it breaks down, here's a category parameter or the query parameter, so that way Google can end up tracking it. You also want to create your own dashboard. By creating your own dashboard, you can see the metrics that are the most important to you. So in Google Analytics, go under Customization, and of course, click on Dashboards, then click on Create, and then you want to create your own dashboard by coming up with the name. I like selecting Blank Canvas, and then you can select the metrics that are most useful to you. Whether it's goals or people abandoning your funnel or exiting, you can pick all the ones that are related to driving revenue. And the key there is ones that are related to driving revenue. I wouldn't create a dashboard with a ton of vanity metrics. Vanity metrics are metrics that don't move the needle, don't make you money. So make your dashboard with the metrics that drive conversions. And you can also adjust the layout of your dashboard. I like using it split screen with, you know, something on the left, something in the middle, and something on the right. Now, last but not least, when we talk about Google Analytics, I want you to create alerts. Alerts notify you when something is happening that's good or bad. Remember, we are busy. You're busy. You don't have all the time in the world to log into Google Analytics every hour. Heck, you may not even log in every day. So by creating alerts, you can track spikes in traffic or drops or plateaus or goals going up or down or revenue going down or bounce rates going up. You can track whatever you want when it comes to your alerts. So within the sidebar of Google Analytics, click on Create Custom Alerts, then click on Manage Custom Alerts, then click on New Alert. And you'll want to name your alert, and then you want to select what the alert would be and click Save. By doing that, you'll get notified every time something important happens, so that way you don't have to constantly check Google Analytics. So some action items for you before we go: set up your own dashboard, create your own goals, and download your SEO Taskmaster worksheet. The first two aren't really downloadable, it's more so actions for you, but the third one, definitely download that. I look forward to helping you grow your traffic.